Hey everyone, it's Justin again. Now that you know where geometric sequences get their patterns from, you're in a good place to understand how to write formulas for them. So that's exactly what we're going to do in this video, starting with recursive formulas. The recursive formula for geometric sequences is fairly simple. We already know what everything here means. Any term in the sequence is equal to the common ratio times the previous term. And we have to know what the first term is. It's just a fancy way of writing multiply by the common ratio to get the next term. For this sequence, 5, 15, 45, 135, etc., how would we write the recursive formula? First, let's take a look at what we need. A sub n and a sub n minus 1 change based on what term we're looking at, but the first term in the common ratio will be easy to find. The first term for this sequence is 5. The second term divided by the first term gives a ratio of 3. Same for 45 divided by 15 and 135 divided by 45. So the common ratio in this sequence is multiplying by 3. To write the formula, we just put those pieces where they go. Any term is equal to the common ratio, 3, times the previous term, and the initial term is 5. So this formula would give the geometric sequence that starts at 5 and multiplies by 3 for every term after that. Let's try this one now. Do you remember what causes a geometric sequence to alternate signs between positive and negative? We can see that the initial term is 3. To find the common ratio, we divide each term by the previous term. Negative 27 divided by 3 is negative 9, and we get the same thing for the other ratios. So that's what's making the signs alternate. When you multiply by a negative, the signs change. Now we've got everything we need to write the formula. The common ratio is negative 9, and the sequence starts at 3. Pause the video and see if you could figure out the recursive formula for this sequence. Let's see how you did. The first term is negative 64. Negative 32 is half of negative 64. Negative 16 is half of that. And negative 8 is half of that. So the common ratio is 1/2. With those two pieces of information, we can write our formula. How'd you do? When we learned about arithmetic sequences, there were two different forms for the formulas you could write, and that's also the case here. In the next video, we're going to learn how to write the explicit form for geometric sequences. See you then.